today's video, I will show you how to add a 3D model to a video using Cinema 4D with Redshift 3D. I first need to break the video I want into a JPEG sequence. I can do that in After Effects. In After Effects, I will upload the video by going to File, then Import, and then select File. I will navigate to where I have the video, and then select Open. Now, I will make the video into a composition. Perfect! The composition will open, and you can see the video in the timeline. You can also see I added a few black markers over the square brick to help me track the video in Cinema 4D. Now it's time to export the video to a JPEG sequence. I'll change the format to JPEG sequence. I'll leave the rest of the settings the same and select Accept. I will now select a destination where I want this export to live. I'll save it to my downloads folder. And create a new folder and name it Video 01 and leave the name of the files the same. I'll select Save and then press Render. Perfect! Let's go to where we saved our files and you should see a lot of JPEG images. This is the entire length of the video. It's time for us to open Cinema 4D. In Cinema 4D, I will change the layout to Motion Tracker. Your user interface should look something like this. Now, with this, we can import our video. On the right side, you will see this window that says double-click to create motion tracking object. Let's double-click it. You can see a motion tracker layer was created, and a window under it now says double-click to select footage. We will double-click it, and a window will appear. Here, we will search for the image sequence we exported from After Effects. I will select the first image and then select Open. Now you will see our video. And when you scroll, you will see it's the same length as the video we exported from After Effects. The background video will appear pixelated. However, you can increase the quality by increasing the resampling to 80. You can see the background doesn't look that pixelated anymore. However, by increasing the resampling, you might lose tracking information. I recommend you leave it at 30%, and I'll leave mine as is. It's time to track the video. Let's go down here and select Full Solve. When it's completed, you will see the pink markers around the video. Those are the tracking markers, similar to what After Effects does. I will now select this menu and mount it over my screen. I'll place it here. It's time to add my center point. I will select Create Position Constraint and then select the marker I want to be the center. When you select it, a position constraint tag will appear next to the motion tracker layer. Now, I will create a floor plane. Let us select Create Planner Constraint and select 3 points on the video. When you select the third point, you will see a green pyramid, and on the right of the screen, you can see the markers that were selected. Now, let us select Create Plane. A floor plane model should be created. When you select the floor plane, you will be able to view it. When we scroll the timeline, you can see that the floor plane moves around with the camera. Now, to adjust the position, scale, or rotation of the floor plane, you need to select the layer first, and then select the Model tool. You will now be able to edit the floor plane. I will arrange it to fit the top of this brick. Okay, this looks good. It is time to bring the 3D model. For that, let's go to File, then Merge Project. A window will appear and I will find where I have the 3D model that I want to import. Here it is. When ready, I will select the Open button. The model will be placed in the position we assigned it earlier. I will rename the layer Iron Giant. And now, when you scroll the timeline, you can see the 3D model stays in position. I want the model to be touching the floor and not floating. To maneuver around, you can use these three tools. This one is for moving around, this one for zooming in and out, and this one is for rotating. The keyboard shortcut for these three is number 1 for moving the camera left, right, up, and down, number 2 for zooming in and out, and 3 for rotating. Okay. I am going to make sure the feet of the model are touching the ground. This looks good to me. Let me rotate the model a bit and scale it more. Yep, this looks really good. Now that I have the model placed, I'm going to use Redshift 3D to preview my render. Under the Redshift menu, I will select Redshift Render View. I will position it here. I'll move this a bit here. Now, to live preview the render, select the play icon. The picture will be previewed on the left side. However, the picture looks boring and we can't see the video in the background. To do that, we need to add a dome light. Go to the Redshift menu and then go to Lights and then select Dome Light. You will see how much better our model looks. Let's go to the right side of the screen and under Texture, let us link our JPEG sequence that we made in After Effects. You only need to select the first image and select Open. You can now see the background, but it's not at its proper scale. To fix that, let's go to the right side of the screen. And under Backplate, let's select the Enable box and assign the texture to be our JPEG sequence. Now, when we scroll through our timeline, you will see that the background stays on the first frame. To fix that, Let's first hide this in under backplate. Select the animation tab. In under mode, select simple. And press the detect frames button. The start frame will be 0 and the end frame should now read the last frame of the video, which for this one it's 208. Now, when we scroll through our timeline, we can see in our Redshift 3D renderer that our model and the background move together. It's time for us to add some lighting. I am going to go to Redshift, then Lights, and select Point Light. Let's move the light source by going to the left side and selecting the Model tool. I'll move the light upward. And I will increase the light intensity. This looks good. I'm going to try to match the lighting from our video. I will increase the intensity more. This does not look right. I will reduce the intensity and increase the exposure. Just a little bit more. Okay, this looks alright. Now, I only want the shadows to be visible on the ground. I will select the floor plane and do the right mouse click. Go to Redshift Tags and select Redshift Object. You will see a Redshift Object tag next to the layer. Select it and go to the Matte tab and check on the Override box. Under General, check the Enable box. And then, under Shadow, check on the Enable box. When we go and preview the scene in Redshift Previewer, you will see the floor plane disappear, and the model with its shadow will only be visible. I am going to scroll to see how it looks now. It's time to prepare the scene to render using Redshift 3D. What I will do is export the 3D scene out of Cinema 4D, and I will then import it back to After Effects, where I can composite it. I'll begin by hiding the background from the Redshift renderer. Uncheck the background box that's under environment. You can see it's gone. However, when we see it in the alpha mode, we can see that the floor is still visible. I only want the shadows to export with the model and not the floor. I will select the floor layer and select the Redshift tag. Then go to Shadow section and select Effect Alpha. That has removed the floor but kept the shadows. So when we export our scene, it will only be the 3D model in its shadows. Now let's go to the render settings. In the output window, let's have our dimensions be 1920 by 1080. Resolution 72, and the frame rate at 30 frames per second, same as the video. And we want the render to begin from frame 0 and end at the end of the video, which will be 208. Now, in the Save window, let's set the destination where we want our exports to be sent. I will save it in the same folder where I have all my files. I will create a new folder and name it C4D01. And name the file Iron Giant. I will select Save. Now, since I want to export the model with transparent backgrounds, I will change the format to PNG and have the alpha channel box selected. I'll double check my settings and then I will select the render to be Redshift. I will leave the Redshift settings as is for this export. When ready, I will press the export key and wait till it's done rendering. When the render is complete, there should be 208 PNG files. Right now, there is one because I just started. Now let's go back to After Effects to composite our scene. Back in After Effects, let us import the Cinema 4D exports. Go to File, then Import, and select File. I will now go to where I saved the Cinema 4D exports. Select the first file, and then make sure the PNG sequence box is selected. And select Open. Let's drag our Cinema 4D import on top of the video layer. And now, when we scroll the timeline, you can see our 3D model is in the video. And there you have it. You now know how to import a 3D model in Cinema 4D with Redshift 3D. If you found this video useful, please leave a like and subscribe to the channel. Till the next one.